Hey everyone, welcome to the Hackathon Prep course. I'm Jad, and I'll be guiding you through it. By the end of this short but packed course, you'll know why hackathons and hackathon-type events such as game jams are valuable opportunities for you. You'll understand the importance of stretching your comfort zone. You'll get tips and tricks on how to tackle hackathon events in the best ways possible. And you'll learn about surefire ways to come up with great ideas that will guarantee great reception. And finally, you'll learn about packaging your projects. But you might ask me, Jad, what are hackathons even? Well, the word hackathon is a combination of the words hack and marathon. Hack because you're usually working within a team on a digital project where you're developing an idea and trying to stitch something up very roughly. And marathon because you need to work together in a short time frame and create something very fast, so it feels like a race and you need a lot of mental stamina. A hackathon is an event usually set up by a company or organization that is looking to find high quality solutions to a problem or is just looking for some great ideas through collaboration between experts. These events are usually on-site, but can sometimes be online or a combination between the two. As you can tell, hackathons are often competitive in nature, where you have a jury that is supposed to look through all the projects and determine the best product, the winner. The winner is likely to receive a prize, and after the event, the organization may also choose to sign a contract with the winning team. Other companies that might be attending the hackathon may also reach out to you with some opportunities. And the best part of all is that it's not just the winners who are benefiting from this event. Everyone who participates has the chance to connect with industry people who might be looking for exactly your skills. And let's not forget all the new experience you learn from participating in these events.
Quick break. This video is sponsored by my own company, Immersive Insiders, and we have some really epic news for you. We are launching Europe's biggest in-person XR hackathon, and you are invited. You and 150 other amazing XR creators from all Europe and across the world are invited to Berlin for 4 days of prototyping, meeting amazing people, having good food, being in Berlin, having amazing time basically, and most importantly, potentially getting funded by Meta and our other sponsors to really bring your idea into reality also. Since we only have 150 seats available, of course, I would highly recommend you to act fast, because once you are approved, it is first come first served. So don't sleep on this. Get ahead and apply now. We're looking forward to meeting you in Berlin, xrcc.events, and there we go. I will see you there. And now let's move on with the video.
Now, the typical structure of these events starts with a meet and greet, where you meet all the participants, you meet the organizers, you meet the different companies that might be there. And then you have the overview that goes over the specific requirements, timeline, focuses of the event, so that you know what you're working towards. Then you have sometimes something called project pitches, where certain people who have ideas can pitch their ideas to all the participants so that it's easier to find teammates and to create teams around a specific project. Then you have the hacking part. Of course, that's the most exciting one and also the most stressful, where you're in the teams working on the project, trying to finish it as fast as you can and trying to come up with a beautiful and finished product. And finally, you have the presentation, where you're presenting your products to the jury. The jury will be able to make the final assessment, and at the end, they will have the decision with the winner, the best product. Now, there's something that I need to clarify. It's actually very rare that you are required to make a fully fledged product in these short hackathons. Most of the time, it's a proof of concept, it's a minimum viable product, or just a prototype. So it's depending on the type of event and how long you have to create it. Now, if you ask yourself, what do you gain? Well, first of all, you're gaining experience. Experience coming from using your already existing skills, acquiring new ones, working in teams, working under pressure, working through stress, having a short timeline to finish the product. All of these will accumulate into very important experience that will help you throughout your life with development. Next up is connections. Of course, you'll be meeting a lot of new people, you'll be making new friends, you'll be meeting industry professionals and the organizers that will open up many doors for you in the future, opportunities and things like that. And finally, the memories. Memories are also a good reason to participate in these events. You'll have so much fun. Sometimes it'll be bad, you'll experience stress, but in any way, you'll come out of it with new experiences, things that you can share, stories, and life lessons. Now, if you ask yourself, what can it lead to in my professional career? Well, first of all, you have the prize that you gain. Sometimes it's a large sum of money that you can reinvest into your own business or use for startups and things like that. Of course, you're gaining all of the business opportunities that unlock themselves by meeting new people there. And you have opportunities for kickstarting sometimes. Certain events will put you into their startup programs and give you the opportunity to grow fast because they know that you have the skills to do so. And let's not forget, finally, personal brand growth. Really, really important, a big emphasis on that during these events. You'll have the opportunity to showcase yourself, showcase your work, share it on the social media so that you build your personal brand and presence, making it easier to reach out to employers and partners in the future. And you might ask me, well, Jad, who are you to be talking about this? What kind of experiences did you go through that have taught you about hackathons and events like these? I actually did go through a lot of different game jams and events like these that have taught me so much, and I'll share some stories with you. If you don't know me already, I'm a developer at Immersive Insiders, and I'm currently creating all kinds of educational material around XR development, including videos on YouTube, these kinds of courses, and teaching at some universities. But of course, my story did not start here. It started on a small island in the east of Sweden called Gotland. On that island, I started my game design and programming education. And in the first week I was there, I already participated in my first game jam. No knowledge in programming, no knowledge in game design, I just jumped into it. And the results were amazing. Even though we had only 8 hours to create a game, my team and I divided the task between us and we got to work. I had to learn a game engine from scratch and a new programming language from scratch. But through tutorials and watching videos and things like that, we were able to create the game. And it was really, really fun. Of course, now that I look back at it with more experience, it wasn't such a fun game. It wasn't the best game, of course. But for us, it was a very magical moment. Being able to create something with no knowledge at all was just super special. Yet, this simple experience taught us so many new skills and got us excited and confident to keep seeking these kinds of events. From then, to keep the story short, I participated in many different game jams and competitions and was able to even secure some prizes at the same time. Not only did these create many lasting memories for me, but they also introduced me to many people that will later be my best friends, my colleagues, my connections to the industry, and all of that. The latest game that I worked on, which was created during a 9-day global hackathon, even allowed me to travel to Singapore with my teammates, pitching to a esteemed panel of judges, and then winning first prize, which opened so many doors for us. And after I was done with my education, I reached out to Immersive Insiders, and now I'm here, working with a wonderful team to create awesome XR development content for you and helping you reach your goals. And that's it for the introduction. I know that it's a bit of a long one, but I hope you guys have enjoyed it and have learned something from it. In the next chapter, we'll go over expectations when joining a hackathon and the importance of stretching your comfort zone. Stay tuned.